We joked at Merry Christmas all day and said we're cutting down from 7 minutes to 6. And then we're going to take out the stanzas of rap and the vitamins won't play. Hello, everybody. Before we start, many of you don't know us, so we just want to give you a little context and say you're both really charming and really smart. And you can keep that in mind. Just, and remember that as we're going. And we're universally adored by our family members. All right, so we just also wanted to add a quick thank you to those of you who traveled today. I know it's not always easy, but Christopher and Mary really appreciated it. And they worked really hard on the guest list because not all the people that they love could be here, but we're all very lucky to have been chosen. So thank you for that. For those of you who don't know, I am brother of the Guerrero people. And I'm Michael, Christopher's cousin. That might seem like a more distant relationship, but I'm also his self-proclaimed best friend. So, and brother, I spent years of his childhood, same room, late night bedroom talks, like a lot of memories shared together. Yeah, I have memories too. Alright, so some of you may be wondering why Christopher has two best men up here today. The answer to that is really simple. Christopher's a coward. So there was about a year-long debate over which of us he would pick. I was thinking he would make a more traditional choice to choose his brother, but there was a choice and a chance he could have picked me, and instead he chose not to decide. So we're just here. Yeah. For real, though. Regardless of who is more important to Christopher, Christopher is very important to both of us. Growing up, we were very close to the family, and one of our favorite childhood activities was video gaming and snacking. Christopher hasn't outgrown either of those activities.
For instance, he does play just as much video games as he did when he was a kid, if not more. And I'm also playing with him, so I'm fully judging him. But none of us are ever surprised if when he collapses into the couch, pulls a cookie out of his pocket, just for some stamina while he's playing.
Yeah, I went to visit him at KU one time, and when I got there, his roommates told me if I needed any snacks, don't worry, he kept a secret stash in his room that no one else was allowed to touch. That's not to say he doesn't love exercise. When he was in high school and he would be grounded, he would tell her mom he was going on a jog, which was ridiculous that she believed anyways. And he would run over to Mary's house, hang out for a few minutes, and run back just so he could see her. Speaking of the origin stories of Mary and Christopher, there's another story I want to share. I don't know if they know that I know, but all of you will know as well. Freshman year of high school, I think it was, Mary and Christopher had this little flirty game they would play, where they would ask each other, who do you want your first kiss to be?
Usually, they would get a shy answer of, I don't know, but one night, they were at our house playing hide and seek, and
there were friends around, and but at one point, they found themselves alone in the field behind our house. Mary thought it would be a good time to ask, Christopher, who do you want your first kiss to be? And as we all know Christopher to be the smooth lady killer, he responded, wait for it, I can tell you, or I can show you.
That is the response, I was like, the rest is history. It's kind of cute. It's more nerdy. And I wouldn't necessarily take advice from him on one-liners, but in all honesty, Christopher, you mean a lot to me. I look up to you a lot. You've always been the ideal older brother, and I've always had to compete to keep up with the bar you've set. So I'm a much better person because I had you as an older brother. And Mary, we love you as well, and we're so happy that you're going to be part of our family. You couldn't be a better fit for Christopher, and we're all lucky to have you. I realized today that I have nothing else overtly nice that I'm saying about Christopher in my speech, which makes me feel like I'm acting a little bit, because I'm doing that as one of the best men. But Christopher is absolutely my best friend, and getting to share the joy that we shared with him and Mary today was one of something I've been looking forward to for a really long time. Mary, while you were an incredible woman, you're really bad material for a best man speech because we couldn't think of anything bad to say about you, which is a good problem to have. But if that's the worst thing we can say, then we are very lucky and we are very blessed that the two of you got married today and that you are joining our family. We really couldn't be getting more gracious, patient, and kind addition to our family. And that's one of the reasons Christopher and Mary make so much sense together. Pure and simple, they are good people. They're kind, incredibly hardworking, and they've shown their dedication to one another over the past 8 years. We know Christopher and Mary don't take their love for granted. They've grown and evolved with one another, which is an incredible thing. That quality, their ability to learn and support one another, is one that will serve them well in the years ahead. Yes, we're excited for you to start a family together, and we look forward to being the co-godfathers of the first year. I really wanted to say that joke, but Ryan wrote it, so he wouldn't let me have it. But that's all we really have to say today. We could go on for a lot longer. In fact, we had to cut any stories out of his speech. So could we please all raise a glass to great people whom we love, to Christopher and Mary. Thank you.